Hello everyone, Genesis Writer here with another Genesis Tips and Tricks video. Today I'll be going over some Ricochet gameplay on the map Haven as formerly requested by someone trying to submit a review film to me. And I would like to start out by saying that something I've been saying in Ricochet films previously, that the ball randomly resets to 3 points on the map, is not quite true. At the beginning of the game, obviously on Haven, the ball spawns bottom middle at this point. The ball also can reset on closed ramp, right here, and at the bottom of open ramp, right here. Okay? Now, I would like to state that these resets are not random. They actually are in a particular order. Once the ball is scored or it falls off the map, after it's reset here, the ball's taken and it goes around and then it's scored or reset, the ball will respawn right here. And then, once the ball is scored or reset from this location or thrown off the map or whatever it is, the ball will reset here, bottom open ramp. And then it switches back to center, then to closed ramp, and then back to open ramp again. I just want to make that very clear because that's something I have been misstating on previous videos, and I hope you understand that it is a, you can tell where the ball is going to go next. It is in a particular order. Now off the spawn here, you're going to see three of our teammates charge top and one charge bottom. That's a pretty solid strategy because if you don't see pretty many people charge top, you can always drop on them from above. And since the ball has a 10-second respawn, there's no sense to charge out and just try to, you know, destroy them bottom mid. You can just take your time right here. It's 3 seconds to reset. So the ball resets. I get this. The girl gets bottom middle. I get that kill. Now, I want you to notice how the only reason I'm fighting this player is because the enemy players have dumbly decided to pull the ball back to their base. And so if they had tried to pull the ball to our lower base, I probably would not be facing this guy. I'm going to over here to get those grenades, and then I'm going to try to make this jump up this side ramp if Gravity Ninja will let me here. And I'm going to jump top mid to get a vantage point. You really, really, really want to use these jumps. And there's a few other jumps I'll show you on the map throughout this game that are really important. As far as the map movement is concerned, this game is one of the best, as far as I'm concerned, in videos I've uploaded on Haven in terms of my gameplay. So I see these guys, and unfortunately I get needlered to heck. I do get the ball carrier one shot though, so hopefully he'll be able to clean up, and there's the assist for my teammate as he cleans up the ball carrier. Ball carrier pushing to the bottom of our base, and I see that both of my teammates have died here, and I see, okay, wow, they're all dead. And this is the number one reason why you want to roll it out with a bolt shot and not anything else. Because there's no way this player, having basically full shields, I'm going to be able to kill him if he only appears here. He has a ball, which means he can melee me and get an instant kill. So I can't get up in his face and melee him after two BR shots. I need to have something that instantly kills him. Well, that's obviously going to be the bolt shot. You can save an enormous, just like this, as long as you're standing in front of your own goal, you can save an enormous amount of golds from the enemy team. And even if you do happen to kill the enemy player, and the ball still goes into your goal, it gets them only 20 points, not the original run-in of 50 points. So you're, again, saving your team 30 points, which is a pretty hefty bonus for that defense there. I probably should have waited here for on our street for my teammates to just push up here a little bit more. That was my fault, really. See this guy on our street, do a perfect nade on him between the pillars there. This nade isn't so good, but I'm just trying to keep these players back, and then get a pretty good player shooting from our plat, top middle. Now this guy throws over, he would have gotten 20 points there if he had gotten it in, I believe, and they would have been gained the lead here. Now I want to point out something right here. For Ricochet, it is vitally important that when the enemy team has control of your base, and you have the ball near your base, that you need to throw it the heck away from your base. And oftentimes, the best way to do this, the best way to keep the ball out of enemy hands, is not to just throw it to somewhere, to some point on the map, because it is possible. Let's say I threw this ball over here to bottom Mohawk. There could be an enemy player over here, like this, okay, who might throw the ball all the way back to our base, and then an enemy player grabs it and runs it right in. The safest thing is just to throw the ball off the map, okay? And if you're not already aware, the ball is an extremely heavy object, and it doesn't react nearly as much to lifts and other things of that nature. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. There's a little bit of inconsistency there, but you get the drift, and I throw the ball off the mat very well. Clean up this guy, top middle. I'm going to charge top middle. I want you to see something here. This is very, very puzzling, the way the enemy player decides to run this ball. He has a teammate, okay, on the street who just killed Lodging Whale, all right? And this teammate is literally looking at him saying, okay, yeah, let's run down the street, all right? Or whatever he said, you know? And this guy pushes up and decides to run top middle. If you see that your teammates are on a specific area, whether it be right over here or whether it be right over here, that's where you need to go to try to run the ball, okay? Don't be like this guy and not look where your teammates are. Once you have the ball, looking for your teammates' positions becomes doubly vital. If you don't have the ball, you kind of have to keep track of both the ball and whether your teammates are alive or not. But when you have the ball, your teammates' positioning is crucial. As you can see, this guy wasn't paying attention. He just gets melted. Right here, I just thruster pack to bottom mid. I love that thruster pack. Now, I would like to state out that some of the reason why people don't... I'm sorry, let me just back up here. Some of the reasons why people don't make this jump is because they're not jumping at the correct area. Okay? I want you to see how I crouch jump right here. You don't jump on this part because you see how this ledge extends? It actually knocks you off. Notice how the ledge sort of conforms with the wall as it gets higher and higher here. That's why you want to crouch jump up here, crouch up this ledge, get to the very as high as you can, and then crouch jump up on top of this. That's why these little like ledges are sticking out right here. And actually, I forget that this little hole is right here in the center. And I end up falling after making a pretty good flanking play. I end up falling immediately. But I do weaken those players, but it doesn't help because my teammate dies there. Now, this is unfortunate, but I do end up getting away here. I thought I was about to die there, but this is one of the great plays you can make, okay, with the thruster pack on Haven, and some of you are probably already aware of what I'm talking about. I won't show the thruster pack jump where you can jump into the lift, turn around, and thruster pack to the top street, but I will show these jumps where, I'm sorry, the lift is glitching out here. This is one of the glitches in theater mode. The blueness of the lift does not appear. Basically, I'm just going to thruster pack in midair over. And all I'm doing right there, some people get a little bit confused. I'm just sprinting. I'm just walking into the lift, okay, just normally. I'm turning to the position I want to be. I'm holding forward on my control stick, and I'm just thruster packing. That's it. And it is even very possible if you sprint into the lift and gain even more momentum to turn and then thruster pack onto the top of this ledge right here, which is extremely useful. Okay, right here, the ball spawns bottom open ramp, should I say. And I'm just trying to grab it for my team. Now, unfortunately here, there's three players here. I'm not going to be able to get much headway here, but you can see me meleeing an enemy player. And that's a really good idea. You want to narrow down their numbers as much as possible. This bad guy tries to charge in from bottom, gets a bad throw again. This would have been their second score for 40 points here, or maybe even their third score for 60 points. Once again, I cannot even begin to tell you how the bolt shot will literally save your bacon on Ricochet. Especially if you're defending at all, you need to have a bolt shot. And even then, it's a variable who's defending and who's not. So you really, really do want to be loading out the bolt shot, or have at least 75% of your team loading out with the bolt shot. So right here, notice how I'm just faking it out, okay? I'm just staying alive top mid. I throw the ball, and unfortunately that gets expertly caught by an enemy player, and then I fake around behind because I have no shield, and then my teammate ends up cleaning up this guy. This guy has the ball. You can see my teammates already ready right there to catch it, and they do. And so this is just a really good back-and-forth game. As you can see, no one has scored yet, and it's been several minutes into the game. This is one of the reasons why I uploaded this film, because it was just really close and really solid gameplay overall. Lajima tries to get the throw, but it goes to the bottom of the map, and the enemy players end up grabbing it. I want to point out something that this enemy player did. Why did this enemy player throw it at my teammate? This enemy player had the ball, he came around the corner and threw it straight at my teammate. The reason why is because now my teammate cannot fire. He has a ball that he can... Notice how he had a scatter shot? Okay? I want you to see that. Okay? Because he threw the ball... And now my teammate can't use his scatter shot or his other weapon. And so it's really, really important to note that if you're in a tight situation, you can throw the ball at an enemy player, and as long as you're about to kill them, they won't know what the heck is going on because they'll be pulling the trigger still. So it's really nice to be able to do that. Unfortunately, I have to reload, and it is very, very possible to kill your teammates, okay? It will not say betrayal when something like this happens. Notice how my teammate is already weak, as I unfortunately am going to pick up this headshot on my teammate here. This is actually very possible to happen. I get the headshot on my teammate and accidentally kill him. It doesn't say betrayal though, because it's going to count as the enemy team's kill. Now I want to point out something here. How I say get this goal. Notice how I jump here. Okay, I don't know why in the world you would not try to jump, because notice how the zone has a very sliver. I'm not, you know, it's like, how in the world are you going to make that throw? Look when I jump. Look how the sliver of shield I can see, like, expands, like, double the size. It's so much easier to throw the ball through that little crack there when you jump up and then throw it. The ball is much heavier than a grenade. You're going to have to aim much further up if you're going to throw it. In fact, aiming further up than you, a little bit further up than you think is necessary is a good idea. Again, using this same sort of jump after going through the lift, except just turning to the left instead and thrusting back in, I will have to say that this jump to over here is much easier, but if you time it right correctly, you can easily jump over here. You just have to do it a little bit quicker. When you're in the lift, you have to just jump up, and then turn really fast, and then press thruster pack immediately. You can't wait on this one. If you wait too long, you're going to end up hitting this ledge and just falling off the map. And completely surprising, this player almost get the double kill here. As I see enemy players on their top street to top middle. Now, we try to again get a throw, but the enemy players are able to pull it away. And I would like to point out here that the main reason why I'm not majorly concerned about this enemy player running away on their street is because one of our teammates just died. Okay, and what that means is that they're probably going to be over by our base right about now. And even then, you can see how, notice how that second blue arrow popped up. I hope you guys can see that. Lodging Whale and you have TS Contact back at our base. I have no qualms that they're going to be able to hunt down this enemy player. And you notice how I see those two dots here as I turn around and I go, hey, my teammates can handle this. So I go back and help Gravity Ninja, who's squealing like a little baby pig because he needs help. So I'm going to, you know, shoot him and help my teammate out here. Gravity Ninja camping with the Boltshot right there, or whatever weapon he's using. Not necessarily the best strategy, as he will eventually end up dying in that position. I use the same jump to get to top mid and end up surprising this ball carry completely. And I would like to notice my strategy here. I want you to notice how I actually stay alive from three people trying to kill me from top mid, okay? This is what I do. Basically, I end up throwing the ball, and I'm going to show this how this works here. When I throw the ball here, the ball actually goes right into this corner perfectly. An enemy player runs, stands next to it, and the ball jumps off the map. And I'm literally not even joking. The ball just jumps off the map. The enemy player doesn't hold it. It just jumps off the map. I have no idea how this happens. I'm guessing a grenade or something hit it mildly. So I throw the ball, the ball falls off the map, but notice how I completely get away here, and I just run away here, and even from this player, how I just avoid by sprinting slightly to the left there, jump straight back into the lift, and then make the same jump. Notice how I make that very fast. I turn very quickly to the left and make that jump. This player is an idiot. I'm just going to have to say, if you are like this enemy player and you are no shields, the first thing you want to do right here is you want to turn around and you want to run up this lift, okay? But he ends up just staying out in the open and just, like, lets me kill him. It's kind of embarrassing. Like, you don't want to try to stick the enemy player. And even loading out plasma grenades is just a bad idea overall. Better than pulse, but still. Now, this is a great maneuver by my part. This is how you want to use a thruster pack to stay alive. Actually quite hilarious, because then the enemy player tries to use the exact same maneuver and ends up falling off the map like a complete and total idiot. This is why the random kill pops up on my kill feed. Just wanted to explain that briefly there. I do thrust back onto the ball here and make a great escape by jumping bottom mohawk. You can call it this bottom trophy if you want, because of the trophy-like structure in the center or the pillar here. So then I'm going to try to make it over here, and unfortunately I'm not able to do anything, so I throw it off the map. This is just to prevent them from getting it, and I also want you to point out how all three players are here, and I'm going to reset the ball to over here, which is a pretty good position, because overall the enemy team has to find their way back to top mid, and I just notice how long I stay alive here using these jumps back to top mid, and I'm going to go straight for the ball again. One of the players was asking, how do you play Ricochet? I keep forgetting to, you know, to go for the ball. The main way to not forget to go for the ball is to go for it constantly, to keep it on your mind constantly. Act like it's a moving hill that you have to keep control of. You don't necessarily have to be carrying it. Just make sure that the enemy team is not carrying it. Especially if you want to play the game like Slayer, make it out like the enemy ball carrier is the king or something. You know, and you have to kill him and get extra points, which you actually do get extra medal points for killing the enemy team for your own personal score. So they throw it off the map, unfortunately, there. The ball resets bottom middle. So I'm going to try to get the ball to reset. You can see how the enemy players just don't seem to understand. They're all four above me. They don't seem to understand when the ball resets exactly. One of them ends up coming back and trying to get to me, but it's a little too late as I get another throw into their base. That's a really good throw to try to make. And then he had some excellent assault rifle shots to clean me up as I missed most of that bolt shot there. Now the enemy player does again throw the top mid, which is probably a good idea. Probably a good idea to throw the ball top mid, because you can see we're all three on the street here. So it's just, that's a pretty good play overall. This player ends up running, and he throws it straight over our head, which is a great play on his part. I should have tried to jump there. You can throw it over enemy players' heads, even if it just nicks. Like, you can even throw it over the zone, okay? You can even throw it over the zone and have it just nick the corner right here, okay? And it will count as a score. And it's very, very, very hard to stop that, because you literally have to jump up right in the very place that it's going to hit the top of the zone, okay? In fact, I almost think they should have a little box on top, like a little lid on top of this little hologram box so that you could tell where the top of the zone was too. But that's just for Ricochet, in my personal opinion. It'd be nice to be able to see that. So the ball spawns bottom open ramp. We're about halfway through this gameplay right now. Get some good grenade on the player's bottom mid. Great use of the thruster pack, because I avoid a potential second death by the needler. Unfortunately, I get cleaned up by a guy. My teammate has a scatter shot and gets the ball there. Now, what you're going to see me try to do is I'm going to try to push the top of the enemy base. And, of course, my teammate ends up dying. And you really don't want to do this, what my teammate just did, and just stand out in the open like this. Because there's no telling how many enemy players could be looking at you. Because when you have the ball, everyone knows where you are. Which is crucial why you don't want to be peeking out randomly. It's very hard to nade this top ramp area, so I would just have stuck right here and wait for your teammates to push up. But that's just me. Now my teammate's going to try to get a throw here, but he ends up being taken out by an enemy player, which is not surprising. Once again, my teammates are right there at our base to get the stop there. We are only 20 points ahead of the enemy team, and I jump up open ramp here. And I'm going to get some great flanks on the enemy player. Notice how a lot of this top middle gameplay really revolves around flanking. You can sort of leave your teammates at your base to defend if they're good at defending. And you can sort of run bottom middle and run up open ramp. Or you can use these, you know, you can use these ledges right here to just get top middle and start annoying people. That's really what you want to be doing. And just flanking around enemy players so that they don't know where you are. Once again, Lodging Whale, this is a great example. Lodging Whale bolt-shotting the enemy player. The ball still falls into our zone for 20 points, but the enemy team does not get 50 points, putting them in the lead. It only actually ends up tying the score. So you can see this game is pretty close so far. I'm going to try to hardcore stay on this reset here. I don't end up getting this player. I end up backing up. Notice how I use this little ledge right here to hide the headshot radius. He was using a assault rifle, but that's okay. I'm going to back away to bottom. Notice how also I use these sort of angles here. This guy is still looking for me, but I use this angle as I back up clearly over this area, and I just back up and stay alive here. Instead of charging out and dying, which just would not be any help to my teammates in this position. I charge out, get a kill, and then I'm going to stay back here, let my shields regenerate again. I know that this enemy player is not here, because he just got killed. And this is a great push by my teammate here, recognizing that the enemy team, if you see only two players on the top of their base right here, what's the real big problem is if there's two players above you and there's people respawning right here. Those are the main two respawn points on this map. for your team is on your ramp and a bottom your street next to your lift. So what you're seeing is a great push by my teammate here as I end up bolt-shotting one of the players who tries to take him out, and he ends up running straight to the enemy zone. It's weakening this guy for my teammate, and there you go. That push that we just made does not work very much, okay? And I would not recommend doing it unless you know the enemy players are not in their base. The problem with the strategy is that, let's say two enemy players are sitting right here on our base, okay? Right here on the front of our base, and they're charging from top mid. Let's say that we're bottom mid of the ball, and we just got the ball, and we're running to the enemy base, and then, guess what? Both of the enemy players die at our base, because obviously our teammates are going to try to be killing them off. In this situation, killing these two enemy players is a bad idea, because those two enemy players are going to respawn. Most likely, they're going to respawn over here, and all they're going to have to do is literally walk this way and chunk two grenades right where we're going to be running. Okay, and they're just going to blow us up, and these guys on top of their base will be able to clean us up very easily. That's why you don't want to do that. Ball does reset. Closed ramp here. This gameplay is nearing its conclusion, but we still have a few good plays to work through so far. This guy bottomed their street. And I'm going to be cleaning him up right here as we try to get a push on the street. I say, hey, teammate, can you get a push on the street? But this is actually a great fake out by my teammate. He actually just decides to go top mid, because not only do we have teammates who are top mid, but we also have people pushing the street, and I got one dead on their base. So as you can see, this other guy is outside their base. He's not going to be able to get back in time, and my teammate runs in a great goal. One of the best things you can do when you're running in a goal here is simply to jump from here onto this ledge, and then once you're about to hit this open area, you can bet your life there's going to be a guy with a bolt shot sitting right here. What you want to do is you want to jump, okay, and then jump straight into the top of the goal. You can also, and this is kind of funny, you can also jump on top of here. They don't really expect that. They had a hard time aiming at that, and then you can jump on top of the goal as well. And those are just some of the strategies for running in the ball top middle. Yeah, they could double kill on players. And gonna end up just hanging around this ball, trying to make sure the enemy players don't get it, making sure they're weak. That was a crazy headshot right there. I don't even know how that happened. Shooting guy bottom middle. My teammate takes out a guy who was open ramp just above me, probably saving my life there. The enemy players are debating a little too much. This player, he ran this way a little bit and then ran this way. You need to be pushing with your team. You need to be behind your teammates, obviously, or just behind them. But it's almost like football. You really, really do not want to be hanging way, way, way back on the field, okay? Because when you do that, you're just going to get sacked from nowhere, all right? And that's literally what this guy is doing. He's debating way too much and gets easily killed as I get the double kill here. A ball spawns once again, bottom mid. An enemy player is top, so I'm going to try to throw the ball and get out of here. I should have tried to grab the scatter shot here, but my teammate ends up grabbing it. I'm going to just keep the ball alive so it doesn't reset. And this is a brilliant play on my part. And I want you to notice why I do this. Because there are so many enemy players bottom middle right now. There's a guy here, there's a guy here, you know, there's just people over here. They're not going to expect a sudden movement of the ball top and then a run in straight to their base. They're not going to expect that, okay? And so I throw the ball up here, and the ball actually does end up going right here as my teammate. I call out to my teammate, hey, I'm throwing it here. And notice how I'm just keeping these guys distracted on open ramp. And obviously I'm going to die here, but my teammate gets a good throw at their base and is able to get some more score there. So we only have 40 more points to win. These guys' defense disintegrated quite horribly at this point. And I get needlered by this guy. This is my second needler death in the game. That's okay though. I'm just gonna respawn top our street. Notice how I did spawn top our street. I do say like these spawn points, bottom street and the our ramp are the main spawn points. Why I'm saying that is because if you have control of top middle and you have at least one guy sort of on the street, they're mainly gonna spawn in those two locations. You can't have other spawns though, like I just had. It all depends on where you're controlling. So here's a really good angle on some enemy players. I end up pushing in here, trying to just really do some damage to the enemy team. I have regained, or had, most of my shields get an excellent nade on a few people. I really wish I would have gotten a triple kill here, because the third guy I'm firing at right here has no shields, the guy who just killed me. But that doesn't end up happening. I thought we were going to make a push there. There really wasn't any need to, though, because the ball was resetting. That's probably a lack of call out of my teammates and also just a lack of awareness on my part. It's never completely your teammate's fault. There's always something you probably could have done. Oftentimes, it just requires a hard mind to think about it later to understand what you did wrong. Now, right here, again, an excellent push by my teammate. And he didn't need to walk it in because we only needed a few more points left. So there you go. That's the end of that game. I hope that game gave you some great examples on how to play Ricochet better on Haven. I hope that just helped explain to you some of the more complex maneuvers you can pull off. Gave you some ideas on where to throw the ball and things of that nature. There's a lot of places you can throw the ball that I didn't even go over. Like, for example, over here, you can definitely throw the ball to the enemy base. But the problem is a lot of people see this coming. When they see the ball reset over here, it is very smart to keep one teammate back here until you know that the ball is not going to be in enemy hands, because you can easily, or you can make a throw from over here. It's not as easy to make as that throw from their bottom street, but it is very, very possible to make a throw from there. It is also possible, and I have seen it actually happen, to make throws from right here. And that is also a very difficult throw to make, but you can do it. So guys, I hope this film helped you out on how to play Haven Ricochet a little bit better, and I'll see you on the next capture or whatever I end up recording. Peace, guys. Hagstroms is the best player in the world. Happy late April Fool's.